Hi, I'm Dr. Feng Mushtaq. Today we are going to discuss the Swish network. An internet is a switch network in which a switch connect at least two link together. A switch need to forward data from network to another network when required. The two most common type of switch network are circuit switch and the packer switch. Firstly, here with the example show that this one is the circuit switch having a dedicated connection. This dedicated connection is called the circuit, okay, that is always available between the two end system. The switch can only make it active or inactive. Okay, this figure show that a very simple switch network that connects only four telephones to each end. We have used telephone set instead of computer as an end system because circuit switching was very common in telephone network in the past, although part of the telephone network today is a packet switch network. Here you can see that the four telephone at each side are connected to a switch. The switch connected a telephone set at one side to a telephone set at the other side. The thick line connecting the two switches is highly capacity communication line that can handle four voice communication at the same time. The capacity can be shared between all pair of telephone set. The switch used in this network have forwarding tasks but no storing capability. For example, we discussed the two different cases here. The first case, all telephone sets are busy. The four people at one side are talking with four people at the other side. The capacity of the thick line is fully used. Okay, this is the one case. Another case, only one telephone set at one side is connected to the telephone set of other side. Only 1/4 of the capacity of the thick line is used. This means that the circuit switch network is efficient only when it is working at its full capacity. Most of the time it is inefficient because it's working at partial capacity. The reason that we need to make the capacity of thick line 4 times the capacity of the each voice line is that we do not want communication to fail when all telephone set at one side want to connect it with all telephone set in the other side. These are the two cases for the circuit switch network. Next is the packer switch network. In computer network, the communication between the two end is done in a blocks of data called packet. As the name represent, packet switch network, which show that the data can be divided in different blocks and the communication between the devices with these packets, different blocks of packets. In other words, instead of continuous communication we see between two telephone set when they are being used, we see that exchange of individual data packets between the two computers. This allow us to make the switches function for both storing and forwarding because a packet is an independent entity that can be stored and sent later. This figure show that the small packet switch network that connect four computer at one side to four computer at the other side. A router in a packet switch network has a queue that can store and forward packet. Okay, here you can see that. Now assume that capacity of thick line is only twice the capacity of the data line connected to the computer to the router. If only two computers, one at each side, need to communicate with each other, there is no waiting for the packets. However, if the packet arrive at one router when the thick line is already working at its full capacity, The packet should be stored and forwarded in order they arrive. Okay, all the message are divided into different blocks. If the capacity of this communication line is fully occupied, fully busy, then these blocks are waiting until the capacity of the line is free. The packet should be stored and forwarded in order they arrive. Okay. The two simple examples show that the packet switch network is more efficient than the circuit switch network, but the packet may encounter some delay. Okay, in case if the capacity of the channel of the communication link is fully occupied. Okay, this is the today lecture. Here we discuss the circuit switch network and the packet switch network. Thank you, everyone. I advise you to subscribe this channel, that help you for the future videos and time to time videos that I share for your class. Thank you.